Hey folks, Dave here, and welcome back to Attila Total War. This is our Scourge of the North Viking series with JERMGaming.
Hey guys.
And we've been playing catch up. It's been a while since we last played, but the steamroller is in full progress right now.
It is. Last episode we took Tlerfidum. We've decided that the Saxons have been unhappy with our continued domination of their lands for a while, which saying it like that way sounds like we're being unreasonable, but we're the Vikings. So we've decided that they've been unhappy for too long, and we are liberating them of the need to be unhappy. So we have taken Tlerfidum. I'm going to be taking Angulus and Phlevum while sending an army south to help Dave take Avaricum and Vienna.
Yep.
And the Saxons will be basically done. They'll still have Aquia Sextae further to the south, but at that point, that won't be a big deal to take out. So Dave will be taking Vienna, Narbo, and Aquia Sextae.
Yes.
And then Avaricum is in the same thing as the same area as Luis Elusa and Burgadalia. Well, let me see. The Angles don't like us. The Gauls do like us, so we may not take that whole area yet. But yeah, Vienna and Aquia Sextae.
We take this settlement for the tribe.
And then we'll see who hates us next.
It looks like Avaricum is wanting to put up a fight. Shall we?
Already?
I'm going in. Yeah.
All right, let's do it. All right.
I thought we were inviting things. I'm clicking attack.
This pulse pounding action. How can you guys even comprehend what's happening? Yeah! Oh, we're 1776. Well, that's a very freeing number. And we're taking on 970 or something.
Yeah, I just want the best ratio possible, you know?
Oh, you have some catapults there, it looks like, or some trebuchets.
Do you like, do you like catapults?
Did you get some?
Yeah, I got some. I test drove yours, and I was like, yeah, I like this.
Which of my 30 catapults did you test drive? I kind of bummed that Tlerfidum didn't put up that much of a fight, because just think if those catapults had to actually slug it out, like against a fully armored city, that would have been amazing. As it was, we just hit the gate a couple times and then marched in.
But the debris, like, falling out from under their feet as they tumbled to their fiery dooms was still pretty sweet.
It's a very Viking way to kill somebody.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, what can I have? And I'm these onagers. I'm excited to see how they're different from the regular catapults. By excited, I mean, like, real-time strategy excited.
By excited, you mean you're asking for the catapults.
No. You can keep the catapults. Just give me what you normally do. Give me some skirmishers and stuff, and I'll hit them from behind.
You don't want the catapults?
I mean, I'll take the catapults and the skirmishers. But I think my biggest boon to you when it comes to battlefield tactics is hitting the enemy from behind while you do the frontline management, because you're better at that, so.
Okay, well, here, I'll give you a mixed force. How about that?
All right.
You also get one catapult.
One cat. Ooh.
I am a kind lord.
Oh, I do pledge my service.
It's that map. You recognize it?
No. Is this the?
This is.
Yep. The same Angulus. The Angulus map.
Yeah, I think it's been changed a little bit, but it's basically the same unconquerable hill.
Well, unconquerable till they met us. As soon as we see where the enemy is, I mean, we're just going to annihilate them. Has the battle started?
Negative. I'm doing formations, because...
Okay. So I'm saying, let's put the catapults, like, let's spread them out a little bit. Like, I'm putting mine over on the side here. They should be able to hit everything fine.
Okay.
You put yours over to the side. Actually, I'll put mine on the side that all my troops are on.
Yeah, I'm going to keep it close, but I figure I'll put a few shots towards the tower, but I'm going to actually try to capture the tower. The catapults are going to focus on troop concentrations.
Sounds good.
We hunger for blood and battle.
Speaking of troop concentrations, fire!
All right, I'm going to go with flaming rounds, just because that's kind of a jam.
The enemy approaches.
As you do. My warlord is going to stay back because that is my prince, so I'm trying to learn to not throw him into the melee immediately.
You've only been through 15 or 20, so...
I'm running out of airs at this point.
Ready. Warriors, move out.
Well, I'm gonna go ahead and move people in. They're pretty sure they Yeah, they're pretty sure they want to do this, so whatever.
Oh, nice, you got the swordsmen up front. They're gonna tear through those spearmen.
So you wanna capture that tower?
It's generally faster if you're moving in to just capture it as you go by than try to, like, siege it.
I'm gonna throw my slingers at it because they're kind of useless in straight on battles anyway.
Have those slingers target this cavalry. See it coming out right here? I mean, that's the main gate, so I guess you probably see that.
I'm actually going to... I'm just doing what I'm doing with the... Let's see. Yeah, they're about to get run into pretty hard there.
Our troops are being ambushed.
They are getting run into pretty hard.
Yeah, that was a rough charge.
I've got spearmen coming in.
Got new light skirmishers coming in from the top.
The men are broken and running for their lives.
Not for long, they're not.
I'm still going to try to run my slingers into that tower just to capture it. I don't know how well that's going to work.
That's fine.
I'm breaking some of their swords. I wish we could have gotten our spears in position to hold them at the gate, because then we could have just beaten them to death with catapults. That would have been the best strategy.
They ran out really fast.
Yeah, my guys are breaking.
Okay. I'm going to try and hit that cavalry. I don't like that being over there on the side.
I'm going to have my spears start charging.
Okay.
Our men have given up and are running for their lives.
Yeah, that cavalry.
My men will rally pretty quick. I'm not worried.
Cool.
Nobody was seriously hurt.
Take
this high
ground.
All right, I'm chasing them back towards the gate.
Nice.
I mean, we're gonna win this one. I just want to preserve as much of your army as possible.
Yeah, I wanted to fight this out because the numbers were, you know, closer than the overwhelming majority I prefer. That fire tower is...
I'm up in the gate over there, so I'm going to move my guys up and hit the gate with the catapult. The onager, technically, for all you Total War fanboys. Okay, I've broken one of them.
A unit is running from the enemy.
I'm gonna move up and hit those spears again. And now they're clustering the gate, which is their mistake. That tower is kind of hurting us.
Yeah, it's annoying. Let's target it.
Yeah, we can get rid of it pretty quickly.
Melee fighters ready.
Hit the tower.
I'm gonna switch to barrage.
Oh,
it's not a moving target, so it should be pretty easy to take it out. I'm pretty sure the tide of battle was already in our favor, but thank you for acknowledging that, Total War.
I was going to say.
The king's coming out to hit my side.
I'm deploying my spearmen. That tower's about to go away.
Yeah, I'll just slug it out with them while we get rid of the tower.
You have our spears! Gotcha!
I'm actually not having great accuracy on the tower.
That's about to go, though. 78% damage. I'm firing stones at it now. Yeah, that thing... If I had realized that they were going to charge out of the gate, that tower would have been an earlier target, but...
I'm missing the target, that's my problem. The barrage thing, I thought they would be more accurate since they were shooting it at a stationary target, but that's
it's
not
just
the case.
A faster rate of fire, I think.
I just broke their general, though, so...
Oh, nice.
The enemy general is dead!
The general is dead. Ready. Fantastic. Fantastic. Let's go ahead and take the town, guys.
Goodbye, tower.
You destroyed the enemy tower!
I'm going to take off their speed, let them just walk a little slower, regain some of their composure.
Oh, what are your catapults doing?
That was temporary.
Okay.
They're redeployed now.
Once more, into the breach!
I'm going to actually have them stop firing so that they don't damage the town any more than necessary, since we have it in the bag. better to slow the fight through.
Well, that's cool. If you zoom in, our men are cheering as they march, like slow march into the city. That's kind of cool.
Battle ready and eager.
They're cheering as they march kind of in the wrong direction because their pathfinding isn't great, but you know.
They're distracted by their happiness.
Looks like we're going to deal with some skirmishers when we get up there.
Hey, their morale is already...
Alright, my guys are eager, so we're going to start charging as well.
There we go.
A glorious victory will soon be yours.
And my guys are going into a close wall formation.
We won.
Alright, cool.
I'm going to take that and run with it.
Yeah, that's just a minor battle.
Lots of losses, though, so that army is going to have to sit for a few turns.
That's okay, it'll take a few turns for my army to get back, and then we can easily crush the next town. So, I mean, that's our goal here. We're not trying to roll the dice, really. We have enough armies that we can steamroll pretty much anywhere in our immediate area, unless the Huns all show up.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm just going to occupy.
Ready for battle! Ready for order!
As kind Vikings do after a good conquering.
A good conquering. That's just a weird way to describe it. Oh, look, Vienna has sickness now. Great. You guys just suffer.
Yeah, I'm like, maybe I won't march there next for a while. I'll make a save here.
Warriors all.
Can I recruit anybody for this army? No, they're kind of topped off. Let me check for upgrades. Ooh, we do have some new skills. Let's do... I'll do some cunning, and then some authority.
Ready for orders.
Trying to remember... Okay, right, there's the upgrade option. I'm just checking for any possible upgrades.
No, it's okay. I expect it.
I'm going to merge a couple of these badly injured units together so I can recruit new guys. That's kind of a cool tactic. If you have units that are like at 1/3 strength, merge them and then go ahead and just start recruiting replacements.
Yeah.
We need good fighters. Come! Fight for us.
So Avaricum, that's going to get you 283 per turn, even in its damaged state. That's pretty good.
That's not bad. All right. I call that success. Provincial governor available. Ooh, new region.
And the Western Roman rebels and the Western Roman separatists, they're probably going to be the next big problem because they have, like, a lot of stuff near us.
Yeah.
And we're technically at war, I guess, if you want to get down to it.
Let's do an edict here. Let's do the one that is my usual one, which is... Oh, I can't. The one that usually makes people happier. I can't do that edict.
They don't want to be happy?
It might be just the region of the world that I'm in, or maybe I have too many regions under that religious edict already. Oh well, I'll do one that increases my military research, which leaves one final thing to do, which is to assign this skill back home. I'll just do the usual, like, melee defense. There we go. I'm gonna leave my king in your former capital, so I don't forget he's back there.
Wait, which is my former cap? Oh.
Yeah.
Heroic Assault?
Yeah.
Oh, the Saxons, they're riding. The Frost Bears, they're running away. They're running towards my area of France. So hopefully, taking all these areas will get our cash flow up enough. Like, right now, I've got so many towns kind of in the works that are doing upgrades back home in Britannia. I feel like if I get Britannia fully upgraded, I'll have the cash flow necessary to just really start making capital improvements.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'll have capital one day.
You let me know when this turn's over. You let me know what you, if you're running a deficit.
Negative 108, it says, which I have plenty of stock right now to deal with. I have 1,100 in the treasury. So.
Wow, 1,100. All right, so the Roman Separatists are going to fight the Eastern Roman Empire. That's good for us. And there were marriages. I don't remember setting those marriages up before, but congratulations for those people.
I seem to remember you trying to marry off most of your family in a wild fury of clicking last
episode.
Remember
when we were going to study how the family system works and we didn't, and now my power is merely acceptable.
Remember how we were going to get better at this game and then Blood and Wine came out?
I'm going to secure loyalty from everyone possible. All right. So I'm going to take the warrior scouts. You said you didn't want that many catapults, so you're not getting that many catapults.
Okay.
I'm sending them back. Hopefully the Alamans are not upset by us me trespassing, because I'm technically trespassing. And then I'm going to go ahead and take Angulus.
Okay.
Yeah, let's do this.
Let's go up there and look. Oh, wow.
Want to fight it or auto-resolve it?
Looking at just the map, I'd say auto-resolve.
Oh! All right.
Yeah! Oh! What's the numbers? I can't see the actual numbers.
It is 1770 versus 780. I'm going to go protective because I have missile superiority. And there we go.
Oh, all right.
There goes his head. That's a lot of blood. Fantastic. I guess I will just occupy, since I don't really need their money right now.
Dude, there is blood all over that town on the map now. Just everywhere.
It's good. It's good. And then let me see if I can get... I can get pretty dang close to... What's this called? Phlevum. Which has a little bit of an army.
And don't forget, their king is right here off the coast to the west.
Yes. But I can't really fight him from where I am, so...
Yeah.
Well, Telerfordham's doing all right. It is actually turning a tidy profit, and I didn't even damage it that much, so... Cool.
Watch that happiness, though. Negative 45 per turn. You're going to have a rebellion in, like, two turns.
I will, but I mean, I just captured it, so...
Yeah.
I'm not going to really count that. Okay, so... The Saxons are over by this desolate Colonia Agrippina.
Can you mark it?
Yeah. There shows disease being there. That was a terrible marking, I'm sorry.
what is that?
I don't know. So, looks like there's disease there, but it's not settled. They're just near it, so I'm not really sure what's going on with that. But
oh, that really sucks. You're living in rubble. Also, there's sickness.
What a great description. You live in rubble. Also, there is sickness.
Life is bad.
Everything suck. Go away.
Bring social services with you. We need water, housing, medical aid.
All right. Yep, so next turn, the wheels of hellfire are going to roll Phlevum. And I will probably send the Spirit of the Forest back to Lurphidum to keep the peace, and Angulus can just suffer along doing whatever it wants to for a while. Hopefully I did not make the Alamans angry. I don't think there's anything else I can do right now.
I would suggest maybe next turn, if a territory is going to rebel, let it be Angulus. Just take your army back to Lurphidum.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to do that.
Yeah. Reward, call to arms if I raise a fleet. Ooh, I get a military training, what's the word? Like a research perk, if that happens. And how much is that one worth? I'm looking for it.
That rebel army is up to 12. I actually might need your extra army to come help me when I take them out near Augusta Trevorium.
Can you mark that too?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't get a research. I get a few turns of like military, I guess, morale bonuses.
Gotcha. Yeah, there's the issue I'm going to have, because they're up to 12 now. They're just going to be more by the time I get to them, so.
Okay, I'll see what I can do. I'm going to raise just like a single fleet for that bonus, just because.
Thirsty for battle!
I think I can handle them on my own. I just don't want to decimate one of my armies, since I've got three stacks going right now.
Ready for cool. Orders!
I built a fleet. Let me see, do I actually have a fleet somewhere else? Oh, that's my king, Black and Sails.
I think last episode you were doing something with a fleet, and I don't remember what it was.
It needs to be built up, but I can't afford it. They're just super injured right now. Let me focus on the armies. Let me go back down here to the south. My Bloodsickles army is replenishing very quickly.
Ready for battle.
Let me see if I can do a...
They should probably stay there a couple turns. That'd be smart.
Well, I'm going to do a tactical switch here. I'm going to put the Bloodsickles in Lugdunum. Going to repair those buildings that I captured. Whew, now the money's eroding. And I'm going to bring my army north to help you up here at Augusta Trevorum.
And I'll have my army there like within a turn or two, and I can help you take your next people. But
oh yeah, I'll one more turn for a bit. And I'll be there. So
yeah.
Cool. Vienna is now disease-free and ripe for the taking whenever I get around to it.
They just got their papers. They're clean and good to go. We'll be there soon.
There is a food shortage in Aquitania. Let me end the turn. So many upgrades for all my generals.
Come on, Franks, what you got? That's what I thought.
Skip.
The Sassanids always have a long term, so I'm looking forward to seeing what happens with them when we finally find them. I believe they are the southeastern portion of the map. Because I'm playing as them in my regular campaign. I say playing, I haven't gotten back to it in like 9 months, but...
Oh, you have one of those too, huh?
Well, I got the steamroll going, and then I was just, like, taking 4 or 5 towns per turn. I just did that for a while, and just got kind of bored.
It might be a year since I loaded my single-player save game, and I feel like I shouldn't try to load it anymore. It's been so many major patches since then.
All right, Augusta Trevorium is being attacked, and there is absolutely no way I can win that, so you guys have it back.
Oh, it's a new faction, too. What is that? Palmyra?
They can have it. I'll be back to take it in a minute. Whatever makes them feel better.
Dude, look at the morale for that city.
1 second. There's peace being negotiated. I was decisively defeated. I have a small food shortage because of that. Blah, blah, blah. Don't care, don't care, don't care. All right, what did you want me to look at?
Augusta Trevorum, under its new faction, is at -269 happiness.
Wow. Probably because they were taken, and then they were taken again.
Well, yeah, it's like a new faction, too, that I don't think they're happy with. But is that like a new record for this game that I've seen, I think?
I don't think I've ever seen anything that high, no.
-269 in one takeover.
It sucks for you guys. All right, Flebum. It's been real. Oh, let's fight this one on the battlefield. That's okay. Actually a little closer than I thought it was going to be. And I have a crapload of catapults, so...
Oh, they're going to have to land naval forces, so I wonder if we can break their ships as they land. That sounds like fun. I'm in. Totally in.
Okay, so they have reinforcements of 300 and something people coming, so that's most likely ships. They don't look like they have a whole lot in town. So what do you say we move around to about here and kind of set up our defensive offensive line there?
Yeah, that looks good.
Okay, so I'm going to give you those catapults. And okay. I'm going to give you these skirmishers. So if you focus on anything coming from boats, I'm going to put my catapults here and they can focus on towers.
Okay, I'm going to put some on the high ground back here and some just kind of facing over this way. Because with the snow, they're not going to be able to move a whole lot once things get going.
All right, my archer's back here, so I've got a pretty good line. And then you just form up to that however you want to. And I'm just going to take out a couple towers before I even walk my men in, and then I'll just walk into the middle of town. I mean, that's the whole plan.
Okay, and if things are looking bad back here, don't forget about your king. You left behind,
yeah,
too.
I didn't forget about him.
Am I deployed too far to the left, do you think?
Yeah, you're not going to get into town in any good amount of time. There's no reason to be that far out to the side. If you put your guys a lot closer to where I am, you can still hit pretty much everything, I think.
I'll put some in the middle here. I'm hoping to hit the boats as they come in, but I don't want to have that be my only, you know, option.
Right.
Okay.
Hey,
I think
those skirmishers, why don't you just put the skirmishers all the way on the other side over here?
I want the catapults covered.
Okay.
I can move them once things start. Yeah. All right, boats on the horizon.
All right, I'm going to... Reinforcements! Let's see more for how us far away will those go.
Reinforcements! More for us to kill!
I'm going to go ahead and hit their towers.
I'm actually out of range of the shoreline.
Gods, protect us!
All right.
The enemy has been sighted!
Ooh, they're coming in quick.
Well, the fire is also coming in quick. I don't care about your stupid town. Later, guys. I'm going to go ahead and start walking my spears up.
Okay. I'm going to start firing on the reinforcements. One day, perhaps.
Not a good place to stand there, guys.
They appear to be going towards the town to reinforce.
Good.
I'm gonna go into first person for some of these shots.
Good news.
I'm gonna enjoy this.
Alright, I'm taking out the tower on that side. So I'm gonna start firing on their king.
Hey, me too. Direct hit, I see blood.
And the archers that are kind of in town, I'm gonna hit them too.
Oh. That was a misclick. What's fun about the actual targeting mode is I can kind of snipe people that are very close to your lines. Don't worry, I got this.
Alright, turn off your shot if they're gonna be shooting the armies close to us, because my guys are on fire.
Nope, that was 100% you.
No, your fire guys are hitting them. I turned mine off a little bit ago.
Oh, suck on that, archers.
I'm just going to break the brunt of their defending army right here. Cavalry breaking.
I see him. You got him?
I think so. No, they're getting around. They're going for the catapults.
Copy that.
And the archers took out most of them in one go.
Nice.
Yep, they're already broken.
I'm going to move my skirmishers up to cover your army from the side.
All right.
We hunger for blood and battle. We have gained the upper hand.
You're still flaming shot, by the way.
Yeah, I'm doing direct targeting myself.
Okay.
This was going to be a little bit close.
It's not going to be that close.
I mean, that shot I fired.
Oh, okay. You got guys about to hit your catapults.
Skirmishers got him first. Oh, you mean this guy back here?
Yep.
You guys drop the equipment and help.
I'm running some archers over. Maybe. Nope. All right. They're too stupid. Never mind.
Warriors, eager for blood. Attack!
Huh. My catapults are chasing those defeated units all the way off. Oh. This shot came out of nowhere and bowled over two of the guys. How bad.
After them. Don't let them rally.
Keep firing!
Ooh.
That was gonna be close.
Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and start running spears into town.
Sounds like a plan.
Go ahead and switch your catapults off. They're just firing into an area where everybody is.
I'll have them work on the archers in town. Or they're gonna fire 20 feet into the field, okay?
Missiles ready! Run, Cashew!
Alright, we're breaking some more units.
Nice.
Where are the rest of their troops still?
These catapults are obsessed with firing at lone men in the field next to them instead of the target I gave them.
There's still one ship just sailing around in the ocean, not sure what their deal is.
Let's see. Can I tell you guys to stop? Yeah, don't fire at will. Fire at this ship.
They're running into the middle of town. I'm just going to chase them.
Cool.
Take it.
Missile warriors! Over us.
I'm gonna take this tower and get ready for their reinforcements on this side.
Warriors, move out.
Come on, guys, get over here.
Ready. Get running.
Surrender.
Gods protect us.
Well, town's on fire. I hope you bought Conqueror's insurance.
Ready for battle. Missile armed warriors. Warriors on.
All right, this is going.
Running, cowards.
I'm gonna speed up a little bit.
Okay. You're taking a lot of archer fire from that last unit, being a jerk.
I'll go ahead and charge them. They're going to run away.
Oh, nice barrage from your archers.
Yeah, they're just going to run.
I mean, I would too. Oh, this ship is withdrawing.
Really?
Or maybe he's just going to the corner of the map and stopping?
Alright, I've captured the middle of town. It still reads them as having more people than you'd think they would have.
It's very hard to aim the catapult on fast forward, by the way.
Their tower has been destroyed! This bodes well!
I'm gonna run guys to the other towers, I guess. I still don't see where all their strength is.
Must be a hidden unit somewhere.
Hopefully they're not hidden units, they're gonna come back on us.
Come on, get it, get it. Ugh. Just missing the ship. Barely.
Alright, I'm gonna capture these last towers. Alright, here we go.
Praise the gods! Your victory is moments away!
Nice. They landed and surrendered.
Yeah, I don't know what their plan was. Like, might as well just sail off. Yeah. Gonna chase you.
I would have left.
Well, that hurt me a little more than I thought it was going to. Alright, Flevum is quite literally on fire.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Alright, I'm gonna send my guys back to Telerfidum. And then Augusta, Trevorium, you guys are just going to have to chill for a bit. Because my army, I think because of the forest, they cannot get that close to them. The Warrior Scouts, they're still on the way, but they're a ways off.
Gotcha.
And the Frostbearers, be warned, they are cruising through my territory, probably coming to try to get back towards Vienna. So it wouldn't be a bad idea for you to take the Bloodsickles out on your turn and meet them midway. They are right here.
It's three mercenaries. I feel like our militias could stop it. Though.
But the rebel army that's now 12 and Augusta Trevorim was not that big. I'm just saying, like, you might want to keep an eye on it. You may need to do something about that.
From what I understand, rebel factions, like rebellions, kind of get like a free income to help them, you know, grow. But
do bad stuff.
Yeah, it's kind of like a little cheat for, you know, rebel factions. But the Saxons have to pay for these mercenaries out of their treasury, their main faction funds. So
that's true. Man, all these battle reports, all this stuff. Let's see if I can secure some more power. Because that is what I am all about. Alright, people are targeted. Wait, I think I can do more. Promotion! I'm promoting someone to High Judge, if I understand this convoluted system. Alright, more of my family members into the government. That's the only part I understand about that. Nepotism is the answer. That's what I know. Oh, I have a lot of unassigned skills.
Nice.
Oh, we need a tradition. No provincial governors yet. I'm still bringing them to heel.
Food shortage in Lugdunum.
Ready for battle.
Get over it. Development in voluntary levy.
There used to be a loyalty shortage there, and we're working on it, so y'all just have to wait.
Ready for orders.
My general is back on duty in the north in the Bearded Barbarians. Nice.
Thanks, son.
For the tribe.
This poor army in the north, though, is still in just rough shape. I'll get some more thrall skirmishers going, I guess, in the northern army. My funding is, man, just so low. I've got to get some income going somewhere.
Just got to take more places. Be warned, the Franks have two, like, 10-stack navies that are somewhere near us.
I don't think just taking territory is the economic answer, because at this point, I own a significant chunk of Europe, and my income is still negative. Like, I've got to make some kind of economic development here.
Well, some economic development, yes, absolutely, but
here we go, serfdom. Description: the lords rule, the people toil. It's the way of things. That increases my research rate to 111%. Also, plus 5% wealth for a bunch of buildings. So I think that is a good one. It's going to take 11 turns to research, but...
There's a rebel army near Angulus already. It hasn't even been a turn.
Is there a rebel army just hanging out there? Maybe the bearded barbarians should just chase it south.
Yeah, chase them towards Salurfidum. Wow, you guys came really far.
I have that perk for winter.
Okay, you can retreat. I can get them next time.
Cool.
Thanks.
That's good, because my army still needs, like, let's say three or more turns of replenishment still.
Thirsty for battle.
I'm going to go ahead and be on station at Augusta Trevorum with my army, ready to assist.
Cool. And then I'll show up next round, and then we'll take them.
I lost about, I'd say, 8% of my force to desertion in the snow, but... Wow, I just got King Stannis. Ooh, I see part of the problem. Almost all these towns need a little bit of upgrading. Lugdunum. Oh, Lugdunum, that's right. I'm upgrading that. That's almost good to go. I really hope.
How long till it becomes a real town? Because it's still not turning much money.
Three turns until it becomes a correct Viking town, basically.
Okay, cool. I mean, because that's when things will really... you know, take off for you monetarily.
For now, though, we'll just keep on keeping on.
So I think our goal with the Franks and the Saxons should be to just keep taking towns until they just can't support themselves anymore, and they'll just die at sea or marching or whatever. I mean, I don't think there's like a better solution than that.
Well, I think they're already at that point, given that their only army that I can see for the Saxons is three mercenaries marching west through the snow away from all the burning cities behind them.
They're probably marching towards a city that's not going to be there by the time they get there. That's so smug saying that.
I mean,
keep marching. That's fine.
It's true.
Oh, the rebels are attacking Angulus. You kidding me? They're attacking with 308. I have 193. It's actually pretty split. Do you want to fight it?
That's going to be an awful battle. Just auto resolve it.
Yeah. It'll take a while to put the area down, but I think I can do it. All right.
Oh, Angulus. The thorn in our side.
Thirsty for battle.
All right, people got to some offices, not really paying attention to any of that. All right. Blevum. Alright, the Wheels of Hellfire cannot actually go take Angulus back, but the Spirit of the Forest can, you stupid angles.
Hey, Telurfordum is still pretty happy with your guys gone. That's nice.
Yep, we're going to go ahead and auto-resolve that bad boy. Yep, that's what I like. Decapitations. I'm almost disappointed I lost that many people. All right, I'm going to go ahead and loot and occupy. I don't even care if it makes them unhappy. I want the money.
They're already at like negative 80, so.
Next on the list. Ah, shoot. I don't know if you're going to be able to reinforce. Well.
It shouldn't matter.
Auto resolve. Yeah, you're reinforcing. I'm going to auto resolve this one too.
That's going to be a good fight. You sure?
Because it's already my town. I don't want to burn it to pieces.
That's true.
It's not going to be that good of a fight, actually. We have almost 4,000 troops, and they have 1,100.
Ooh, these are Romans, though. I see lots of cavalry and crossbowmen.
Yeah, I'm saving my battles for more interesting battles. They just took one of my towns back. I'm not interested in dragging it out.
I'll be aggressive. Oh. a lot of squishy sounds.
Nice spine stab. I wonder how they recorded the squishy sounds.
Just get like a bunch of fruit and smash it together. I'll take on warriors and do that replenishment.
All right, so that was a bit of a profitable turn. Not that profit's everything.
I'd take some profit.
All right, what do I have to repair in Augusta? Why do you guys make me do this? Why do you make me hit you? Where? What is Duro? Oh, okay. I can actually add to that. Interesting. I'm not ready to convert you to anything yet. All right. Yeah, I mean, that was a pretty good turn for me. I can't march my armies past me. So the Warrior Scouts, next turn, they're going to be on their way. I'll be in my territory, so I'll be fast again, and I'm on my way to help you with Vienna. It's still going to be a couple turns before I get there.
Oh, don't worry. The disease icon's back, so I don't want to touch it right now.
So do you want me to send... I've got the Wheels of Hellfire, and I have the Spirit of the Forest. They are both in that area with Telerphidum. Do you want me to send another one of those back? Help, because we're not at
just
war.
Just one. That's fine.
We're not at war with the elements. Just one out of three, or just additional one?
Just one. We do need to watch to the east, because past these mountain ranges... look at all the red icons. It's rebel factions all over the former Western Roman Empire.
So I'm going to send another army back. I'm going to just go ahead and do it.
Yeah, that's a lot of rebels.
And I'll just use my existing one to keep the peace over here. That's fine. I want to have a pretty good military presence there. Also, because we have to take Aquia Sextae and Vienna and Bertigalia. Portugala would be smart. I'm going to go into diplomacy and see how much we're screwed right now. Yeah, it's mostly everybody to the south of us. So the Marcones don't like us. Although, actually, they're improving a little bit. The Alamans are very friendly, which is good because I was wandering through their territory. The Huns and the Western Roman Separatists and the Saxons and the Septimians, they're all like the Gauls, the Angles. They're all mad with us. They're all to the south. So we probably should keep our strong presence there.
Try and see if you can trade with anybody, too.
I think I'm maxed out on trading.
Okay.
Thirsty for battle.
Think. Oh, no, I can do a trade agreement with the Alamans.
Nice. Yeah, they're
I
up here.
Add, let me see. They're kind I will of arrange a marriage. I will offer a daughter.
The Alamans are in kind of central Germany area, and I think that would be a good trade location for you especially.
The Alamans?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just offered. They weren't taking it, so I got to offer them like some money or something next time. They have more value than I have for trade, so they're not really... All right, let me see. It doesn't hurt me to go trade with them again right now, does it?
No.
Okay. Let me see. I offer a trade agreement. It's low because... Yeah, they got more stuff. So, let me see. I don't want to arrange a marriage, actually, because I might have to kill them later. I'm going to offer 1,300. Man, chance of success low. They are just not interested.
Yeah, they're just totally not interested at all.
Oh, wait. I had an offer of payments. I did that the wrong way. Let me offer 1,100. They still don't want that?
Send it anyway. See what happens.
I did. I want it. So, nothing for now. I think it's all for me.
I'm going to send my spy east towards all these rebel territories.
I can do the same next turn. I'll start moving mine.
My Odin's Fist army is going to need to go back to Everrakum first, it looks like. There's a rebellion coming pretty quickly.
Alright, I mean, I got my area now, so go ahead.
I'm now earning 133 per turn.
That's something.
Some war happening in Spain. A foreign force. From the Franks. The Wild Hunters is in my territory. Look up here in Western France.
The Wild Hunters. I think that's one of those 10 stacks that was sailing.
Yeah, they're trespassing right now. I'm going to watch that carefully.
I mean, they're obviously going for Tyrannum. Or they're acting like they're going to.
Well, yeah, I thought that before, though. I've had armies just kind of pass through, so we'll see. They're attacking the edge of one of my strongest areas, though, so...
Yeah, I mean, it's their funeral if they want to do something. There is already a rebel army near Phlevum. Are you kidding me? They're probably going to take Phlevum next turn. I'm just going to have to beat this area to death.
Are you sure you don't want one of those armies north? Because I have two in the south.
No, I want two in the south as well, and I'm just going to have one of them north.
Okay.
I mean, 120 stack can keep the area down. I'm just going to have to spend a lot of time going back and forth and hitting them until I can make them happy enough so they love me.
Oh.
Just the Viking way.
I'm going to get rid of one of my fields down here and see what the Viking option to build is, because if it's not fields, what's the other option? It says it's not available for my faction. How are taxes? Taxes are middle of the road. Don't want to mess with those. I guess the waiting game continues then.
Ooh. Big redeployment over there.
Where?
Franks and Saxons. They are definitely coming for that territory you just took.
Have a Rackham?
Yeah. Or hold on, I can't zoom around. A Tyrannum. I guess you took it a while ago.
Yeah, it's been a while.
They're close to it. I think they're going to take it. They're raiding in your area too. I'm definitely bringing both of those armies back.
Okay,
just
need
to wipe them up.
I'll see next turn what my relationship with the Franks is, but I'm going to bet it's deteriorating seeing they're raiding my territory.
Are you not at war with them?
No, I'm not.
Oh, I'm at war with them.
So maybe they're just trying to edge closer to your territory through mine. I'm just in the way. Also, new rebels here. And new rebels here.
Yeah, that's not good. I can't get all the way to that rebel army right there. All right, so I'm going to get my guys into two different towns just to keep them safe.
Cool.
For the turn, and then I should be able to start reinforcing next turn. I can't get all the way to that rebel army. That kind of stinks. All right. I will move the Spirit of the Forest. I will move them close. They can take care of it next time. But, see, in that area, everybody's got a plus 20 happiness now because I do own that entire area. So as long as I can get the Rebel Army before they do something stupid.
Nice.
And I am making a bit of a profit now.
That's a big stack from the Rugians in your territory.
Where?
At Phlevum, actually.
I'm friendly with them, though, I believe. Let me check them out.
But they're just standing there real awkward-like.
We are very friendly, but we are deteriorating very slowly.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
Interesting. Well, if they're at 60 right now, if it drops below 50, they're small.
No.
I don't want to tell you what I'm making right now because I don't want to make you feel bad.
Can I have 400? Then I can do one of my upgrades down here in Lugdunum. Can I have 400?
Don't you have to request it, though?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right.
You may request it.
What if I just keep shouting at the wall?
I'm also trading with the Rugians, so I'm going to offer a trade with the Alamans again.
Okay.
I mean, we're so friendly, and I'm stronger than them. Why won't they love me? Don't understand why it's low. Could I offer them a military alliance? Nope, they're not interested in that. Could I offer them... I will offer them military alliance, and I will offer them a daughter or cousin or somebody. They're still not going to take it. Wow. They're hoping for something more. I guess they want a lot of money.
Yeah, I bet just stupid amounts of money. They're wanting like a long-term advantage in the trade.
Let me just see what it would take. I've got a little money.
Save something for me. I mean,
it's still low. I'm offering 2,300, and it's still low chance. Yeah, I'm just not. I'm not playing their game. That will reflect poorly on them later. Mark my words.
Your report card has been noted. Your HR file has been updated.
I won't fire you, but you're on a list somewhere. Alright, I don't really want to drop the coin to start upgrading some of these towns until that area gets a little bit more stable.
Oh, for sure.
So let's pop back to Britain. Eberacum. Oh, sweet. Eberacum is going to be a city real soon here. Let me see if I can just roll another upgrade or two.
I might request, if it's okay with you, 800 to do an artesian industry building in Lugdunum.
Is that a joke?
You're borrowing
my money for art?
It gives me money, though. 300 from industry.
Okay.
Also, unlocks recruitment of Nordic Brigade for some reason. I don't know why that's related to art, but...
Alright, that's enough money spent that turn.
For now.
Let me go back to the weird family page. Give me your loyalty. You need to marry somebody. You're single. That's not allowed. Oh, she can't marry anybody. Alright, she's just going to gather support. And then... I guess everybody's doing about as well as they can be expected to do. I'm going to try to adopt one of my rivals. I think they're a grown man. I don't know if they're really going to go for that. But if I adopt them into my family, they might like me better.
I mean, you're rich. I might go for it. Rebellion.
Money. It's alright, I'm only making like 4,600 a turn.
Oh, I'm making 118 a turn.
Sorry.
I just don't understand what has gone wrong with my economy.
It's your poverty mindset. No, I think I just own a lot more places than you. I think it's just worked out that way so far.
I don't think so, though. Like, not that big of a difference.
Aren't most of your towns trickling income?
Maybe? I don't know.
Is anywhere actually losing money?
Don't die. Someone's poisoned the king.
Yeah, none of your towns can possibly be losing money, right? Everywhere you've taken is trickling money.
Us. There's food enough for two armies awaiting us.
Just take more places. More trickle.
More trickle, noted.
My people is...
I'm glad the game doesn't keep a running tally of how much money has passed between us.
What's a little bit of loaning money between friends?
It's got to be thousands. Like,
I say
thousands.
It's probably around 4,000 or 5,000 at this point.
Yeah, plenty of hey neighbor.
So it's one of your turns of income, basically.
Well, no, I'm making a lot of money right now. I've lost some troops and I haven't replenished yet, and I've taken a couple towns that aren't built up yet. So on the move. There are reasons. But hey, as long as one of us has an economic steamroller going, I mean, that's something.
That does help.
There are so many rebels.
Yeah, I'm spying a bit to the east. You see what's going on? Can you see that?
Yeah, I see what's going on.
Who's this army right here? This horde? Oh, that's the Huns. They're in the south of the mountain range now. You see them?
Oh, they're coming back. Cool.
Don't like that.
But they're fighting with the... all the other rebels down there, so hopefully they're just going to stay around there.
One could hope.
Well, I'm going to I'm gonna bring the army south and we'll just deal with it as we deal with it.